Okay, anonymous attendee says B6, xanthurenate of 0.37, kynurenate of 1.4, both in their high red end on the ion test, taking 45 milligrams a day of B6 at time of test. Increased B6 further too. Anonymous, can you put in the chat whether you're a woman, whether you know anything about your estrogen levels, whether you are on oral contraceptives, and whether you are menopausal or not. If you hear me and you can put that in the chat anonymously, that would be great. And I'll come back to your question if you do answer that. And I'll move on for now. And man, higher estrogen levels than normal. Okay, estrogen. So estrogen regulates the... What estrogen does is it increases the conversion of tryptophan to niacin. And my guess is that this is probably designed, quote unquote, to increase niacin status in women, especially when they might have the opportunity to get pregnant or they actually get pregnant, to keep up with the energy demands of pregnancy and to support the niacin status of the baby. But it just so happens that there's no clear way for your body to know if you're a man and your estrogen levels are too high for a man, or if you're a woman and you're on oral contraceptives. It's just that that's what estrogen does. So you probably want to look at ways to reduce estrogen. Right now I'm extremely well versed in niacin and fairly well versed in tryptophan and very not well versed in estrogen. So I don't know that I have a good explanation what to do about estrogen. Certainly, alcohol is known to increase estrogen. I believe there are environmental toxins that can increase estrogen. Overweight will increase estrogen. I'm not sure off the top of my head what other things are relevant in the man. But I would definitely say that that's from the estrogen, especially if your plasma levels of pyridoxal 5-phosphate are normal. So I would follow it up with that test just to be sure. But it's almost certainly the estrogen increasing those. And there just isn't good data on how to alter that in a way that there isn't good. So this is mostly studied in women, and it's mostly studied in the context of oral contraceptives. And the context of oral contraceptives, we know the oral contraceptives make these markers go into the urine, but no one has really shown how to fix that. So what I would do with the B6 is I would be very careful about whether there is anything that responds to the B6. So first important thing is that if you have xanthurenate and kynurenate out, the main risk of that actual fact of those spilling into your urine is actually that quinolinate would be building up. Quinolinate is usually the last thing to rise in B6 deficiency. You didn't mention quinolinate being elevated. And so quinolinate might not be elevated and you might not have problems. But quinolinate is an excitotoxin. It both can cause neurotoxicity like glutamate does, and it can also make you hypersensitive to glutamate. So it can effectively make you have glutamate sensitivity. And I have one client where she had very high levels of estrogen and she had very severe insomnia, and 100 milligrams of pyridoxal 5-phosphate, which is the active form of B6, was one of the first things that actually moved the needle in her sleep. But it only lasted a couple of weeks and the effect started wearing off. And so he clarifies that his quinolinate is in the fourth quintile. Okay, so you're kind of in the zone where you're like, geez, the quinolinate is might be a problem, particularly if you have trouble sleeping or if you have trouble with anxiety or you have anything that you might, like Google glutamate sensitivity, headaches and other stuff like that. If you have any of those symptoms, that could be from quinolinate buildup. In that case, my first line of defense against this would be to increase B6 possibly, I would titrate it up to 100 milligrams. You're already at a P5P of 45, so I wouldn't more than double that. Someone's asking, how did anonymous attendee insert dozen questions ahead of mine? I don't know. I think that I'm going in order here, but there might be something wrong with my order. Unfortunately, I don't want to disrupt the flow too much because I don't want to run out of time on this. And I think I can get to everyone. People are upvoting. That's why. Okay. I think I'll get to everyone. And so I just want to go through this straight. And definitely, if it feels like we're going to run out of time, I will start being more selective with what I answer. But I want to finish this. So B6 markers spilling out into the urine. Quinolinate is the primary concern because it's neurotoxic. If there are any signs that you would associate with excessive glutamate, then that's where I would be concerned. I would go on symptoms, increasing the B6 to 100 milligrams. I'd be very cautious going higher than that, even on symptoms. I probably wouldn't stress that too much. My second choice of action would be to lower the tryptophan content of the diet, because that's what's spilling over into the quinolinate. Iron and riboflavin are also involved in that same pathway. In theory, these are B6 markers, but maybe in some people, if iron or riboflavin are particularly limiting and B6 isn't, maybe these are indicating a need for those nutrients. Okay, so first course of action is leverage up the B6 to the optimum point where there's no negative symptoms and you are getting a benefit from higher doses managing the symptoms. Don't go up to higher doses if they're not helping managing symptoms. Don't go over 100 milligrams of P5P. Don't take any pyridoxine hydrochloride ever. Second course of action is look at iron and B6 levels. If there's any things wrong with those, fix them. Third course of action is, if necessary, reduce protein intake or search for low tryptophan proteins and focus on those to meet your protein needs. Providing that you don't go too low, you're going to need at least a few hundred milligrams of tryptophan in your diet to be okay. All of this is secondary to managing the estrogen, which is probably the root cause here. All right. Thank you for your question.